Welcome to the wildlife in my garden, as it changes with the seasons over a full year. In the depth of winter, with the shorter days and the supply of natural food becoming scarce, birds have only one thing on their mind, and that is survival. We can all do a lot to help them by providing a range of food in our gardens to help them through these hard times. The redwing and fieldfare are both members of the thrush family and are winter visitors from Scandinavia. They can be seen in large mixed flocks out in the field, feeding on worms and insects, and also in hedgerows, feeding on a variety of berries. In periods of severe weather, they will come into gardens looking for berries, and will readily eat apples and pears if put out on the ground for them. I'm always glad to see the stock doves with their beautiful iridescent sheen on their necks. More of them now seem to be visiting the garden, as their traditional winter feeding grounds on the stubble fields have vanished due to modern farming methods. Collared doves can start breeding as early as February. This pair are so preoccupied with courtship, they're completely unaware of the sparrowhawk perching above them. The robins have been paired up now since the middle of winter, and despite sharing a territory, for most of the time they've been completely ignoring each other. But as the breeding season approaches, courtship feeding begins, with the male bringing in food for the female. Sometimes, even if she's standing right by a bowl of mealworms, she'll still beg for the male to feed her. Although these two have shared a territory for some while now, there's obviously still some tension there between them. There's going to have to be more bonding done if they're going to breed successfully later in the spring. Thank you. this can be a good time to keep a closer lookout for more unusual visitors, like the female reed bunting feeding with the house sparrows. It has similar colours and is the same size and is easily overlooked at first glance. Early spring and warmer days may be here, but this can still be a hungry time for seed eaters, as all of last year's seed is long gone and there won't be any new for a while yet. A lot of seed eaters are ground feeders, so don't forget them next time you're putting food out. The male reed bunting is easy to identify with its black head and throat. Although not as striking as the male, I still like the subtle colourings and markings of the female chaffinch. If you've never got up at 4 a.m. on a spring morning to listen to the dawn chorus, you will have missed one of nature's wonders. At its peak, the sound of birdsong all around you can be almost overpowering. There are so many birds singing that it's very difficult to pick out any individual songs. It's just like one big choir. It's only later in the day when things have calmed down that you can appreciate each of the individual songs. Thank you. well as being a smart looking bird, the magpie is also very intelligent. You can see this in its eyes and by watching its behaviour. You wouldn't think that 40 years ago, this was described as a shy bird in the 1973 edition of the Reader's Digest Book of British Birds. Spring is really here now, and there's activity everywhere in the garden, and there's also a sense of urgency about everything. Thank you. the desire to get on with nest building now seems to be reaching fever pitch. This male blackbird already has an early brood of young to feed. I'm not sure how many more mealworms he's going to try and get in his mouth. With hungry young nestlings to feed, it's amazing how brave and trusting some birds will become. I don't regard these as tame birds, because once the nesting season is over, most of them will revert back to their normal wary behaviour. The same grey tit has returned now for 3 years running, but he'll only take food from a hand when he's got young to feed. This is not, as you might think, a female feeding the other bird, but just a slightly older juvenile showing early parental instincts, probably instigated by the begging and wide open mouth of the younger bird. Thank you. As spring now turns into early summer, there are lots of young birds about, exploring and learning how to look after themselves. It's amazing how, just like small children, they're attracted by water, particularly the sound of running water. Although the males of the tree bumblebee look quite fierce as they swarm outside the nest, I was quite happy to go in close to film them once I found out that they don't have stings and that they're only there waiting for the queen to appear so they can mate. Once the lucky or perhaps unlucky male has managed to mate with the queen, his job's done and he will die very shortly afterwards. On this very hot afternoon, it was fascinating to watch as the workers at this red-tailed bumblebee's nest formed themselves into a very effective air conditioning system by fanning air into the nest to keep it from overheating. The garden can be a place of peace and tranquility. Then all of a sudden things can change, as with this 10 minutes of mayhem, as all of the bullies seem to arrive at the same time. Now back to peace and harmony with some of the butterflies that have visited the garden. Bramlings are usually winter visitors to the garden, but these two males have arrived earlier this year, and their bright orange breasts are a perfect match for the autumn colours of the rowan and maple trees in the garden.
Thank you.
After the quiet spell for birds in the garden in late summer, I always look forward to the return of roving groups of tits as they forage through the garden in small flocks. They are often accompanied by small birds such as goldcrests and nuthatches. The male on the left, much smaller than the female, and with deep orange eyes and slate grey head and back, used to be a well-known regular in the area, and you could always tell it was him by that black fleck in his right eye. I'm not sure what the purpose of this very quiet or sub-song is, as it can only be heard from a very short distance away. It may be just practicing its repertoire of songs, but I'd like to think it may be just singing for the pleasure of singing. Thank you. The robin is probably the only bird you will hear singing at this time of the year. It will keep on singing right through the winter to ward off other robins from its territory.